ko Sama Vaha’akolo toku ingoa. I'm a singer-songwriter from Glendene, West Auckland, and this is my Kamua Kamuri. So I would say that my genre, I don't really have or stick to one specific genre. I think growing up, I thought I was like R&B and soul, but I'm really not that. I've done a bit of like everything. Right now in my current stage of music, I'd more like singer-songwriter folk. That's my favorite type of music currently. And that's the music I like writing the most, stuff that has like a real strong storyline. But I've also done like pop, fusion, disco for a little bit with some really, really cool mates of mine. I have done a bit of hip hop and like R&B, but yeah, for right now, I would definitely say, yeah, singer-songwriter folk is my current genre.
Took you to this place to tell you you're all that I want forever, baby. Stay, baby, stay. 'Cause everything you do makes me so crazy. I couldn't imagine life without you. Tell me, should I feel this way or just forget about you? About you. 'Cause I will always feel this way, but you don't have to stay for me. No, you don't have to stay. So tell me, do you feel the same about me? Tell me you don't wanna change, I'll understand. I'll understand. Oh, but see, I took you to this place to tell you you're all that I want forever, baby. Stay, baby, stay. 'Cause everything you do is making me crazy. I couldn't imagine life without you. 'Cause tell me, should I feel this way or just forget about you? About you. 'Cause I will always feel the same, but you don't have to change for me. No, you don't have to stay.
I think Tāmaki Makoto, to me, it's very diverse. Like, it sounds diverse. If I didn't know that diversity existed at such a huge scale, I don't think I would be as creative in exploring all the genres that I do, because I don't stick to just one thing. Because I live in a city where no one really sticks to just one thing. the music taste here isn't really defined. Like, everyone has their own sound. You'll find like a lot of genres that I just didn't even know existed anymore, because just so many people are blending so many different types of genres. And the more people that you mix with in Tāmaki Makaurau, the more you get exposed to. Like, I don't think you can put Tāmaki Makaurau artists in a box. I think if anything, they hate that. So just global and very strong and very powerful. And a little bit biased on this answer, but I think that females in Tāmaki Makaurau are really going to show out in the years to come.
Lately I've been thinking about everything I've done, and all the guys I've been with trying to substitute this love, breaking all these promises I made unto myself. I know inside I'm broken, but I hide in someone else, and I don't need somebody's arms to hold me. I don't need a man to mold me. Trust in God and maybe find the old me. Love me, keep on growing, so boys, keep your distance, whoa. Cause I gotta work on me. Yeah, I lost my vision, whoa. And I gained insecurity. I know he's got me, yeah. I just gotta take his hand, cause I know I'm lonely. But that's cause I don't forgive. So Lord, please be my best friend, best friend, best friend. Lord, please be my best friend. Lord, please be my best friend, best friend, best friend. Lord, please be my best friend. I know that I'm human and that you always provide, but I'm always lacking patience and I'm questioning your timing. I do not know how I did deserve such a great love. You said, my daughter, yeah, I got you. I'm here watching from above, and I don't need somebody's arms to hold me. I don't need a man to mold me. Trust in God and maybe find the old me. Love me, keep on growing, so boys, keep your distance, whoa. Cause I gotta work on me. Yeah, I lost my vision, whoa. And gained insecurity. I know he's got me, yeah. I just gotta take his hand, cause I know I'm lonely. But that's cause I don't forgive. So Lord, please be my best friend, best friend, best friend. Lord, please be my best friend. Lord, please be my best friend, best friend, best friend. Lord, please be my best friend. I want us to be best friends, best friends, best friends. Lord, please be my best friend. Lord, please be my best friend, best friend, best friend. I want us to be best friends. Lord, please be my best friend, yeah.
My whānau in terms of that contribution, my uncle, Hilman Vaha’akolo. I was quite young when he was in music. Some parts of his music journey I wasn't even born. But in terms of how it's impacted me and how I represent him. He was a legend back in the day, which I more recently found out because, as I said, I was very young. He passed away quite a long time ago. He was a trailblazer in terms of just the way that he played guitar. My dad raved about it when I was a child, and he, I'm pretty sure, taught my dad. If he wouldn't have taught my dad, I would never learn how to play guitar, because that's kind of the trickling effect. Yeah, he was beautiful. He was very into his art and his music. And then on the other side, my cousin Paul, who is also infamously known as Face Killer, or Tata State of Mind, if you know the song, you love the song. I didn't obviously grow up in South Auckland, but I know the impact that that song had on so many youth. And this perspective of people at the time, and it celebrated the strength of Auaha, which I love. Like, I'm a Westie till I die because I grew up there, but I'm also Southside, very, very hard, even though I didn't live there, because it's my dad's hometown. And that's where my dad's heart resides. That's where my grandparents are buried. That's where Uncle Hillman's buried. And so that's just another side of music. And Paul was, he also passed away a few years ago, but he was so into what he does. His mum, Auntie Pauline, who's also quite infamously known out south, She's also a singer-songwriter. She's written a lot of gospel music, a lot of church hymns, and I know that she influenced him quite heavily. And he was just, what I know of what she's told me, and even just the way he was, is he was very protective in his art because he was just as protective of his people. I do know that he had a tremendous impact because it spoke to a part of South Auckland that the rest of Auckland just didn't understand, that you had to be from South Auckland to really get that kind of the history of people that I loved that wasn't super close to me, but to everyone else, you know, have such a great impact on music, but to me was, you know, my cousin and my uncle until I got older and realised how much history they've put into music in Tāmaki Makaurau.
2006, I walk right in. The kitchen is blue and the living room's full. My grandparents' house. There's biscuits and ice cream, coffee and tea. A massive tin of Milo in the pantry. And always lots of sweets. And I know no matter how old I grow, this place will always be my home, Emerson Road. In 2009, the streets come alive with my cousins and I. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. We're running around and shouting out loud. 12 a.m. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. And we say no matter how old we grow, this place will always be our home, Emerson Road. This place hasn't changed, unlike everyone's weight and everyone's age. It's Christmas. We don't come as often, but still it's a thrill to see all my family and eat till we're full. Merry Christmas. And I say no matter how far I go, this place will always be my home, Emerson Road. Nana smiles at me. She says, last game of dominoes for the 100th time. She's been sick for a while. I go to say hi to Coco inside, and he starts to cry when he sees me, but so do I. He's been sick for a while. I say, no matter how old you grow, I'll come see you at home on Emerson Road. The so did I. It's a gloomy day. It's autumn, but not just, the leaves have changed. Coco passed away. Two weeks gone by, now Nana's so ill. We pray and we cry, now she's perfectly still. They're in heaven now. Cause you see, no matter how old you grow, you'll always find your way back home. See, no matter how far I go, I'll always have a place